Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon. It is a great honor and privilege for me to be present in the second convocation of leading university as the convocation speaker. I would like to thank the university authorities for inviting me to this memorable event and giving me an opportunity of sharing some of my thoughts with the distinguished audience and the graduating students. Dear graduating students, I would like to congratulate you all on this memorable day in your lives. Your hard work and sincere efforts have enabled you to reach this stage in your career. However, you should remember that this is only the beginning of your lifelong journey in various professions and endeavors that you would be involved with over the next 3 to 4 decades. Please remember that you are among the fortunate few in our country who have had the opportunity of receiving higher education. If you look back to the years when you started your school education more than 16 years back, you would find that only about 8% of your friends and cohorts have been able to reach this stage and receive a degree. This percentage is only about 1/3 of the average of all developing countries. Remember that your opportunity of having university education has been made possible by the contribution of your parents and guardians, some of whom are present today. Your university education should have enabled you to acquire the knowledge and skills in your respective fields of study. Remember that although it is a prerequisite for your future success, these are not sufficient. What is equally important for a successful career in the acquisition is the acquisition of soft skills like communication abilities, organizing and leadership qualities, and ability to work in a team. So my advice to you is that as you proceed along your career path, you should try to acquire these skills. If I look back to the time I completed my undergraduate degree more than 50 years back, it was possible for most of the graduates to continue in their profession with the knowledge they had acquired at the university. However, the scenario now has changed significantly. A number of factors, as I mentioned, which have changed the whole scenario. The first, globalization of economic activities. The graduates of today are expected to interact with colleagues from different nationalities who may be working in other countries, speaking in a different language, and having a different culture. Therefore, appreciation of these differences of culture, language, and local practices becomes increasingly important. To overcome some of the language barriers, most countries have accepted English as the language of international official communication. Acquiring competence in the language is therefore becoming increasingly important. I would advise you to make special efforts to acquire these language skills. The second point, the generation of new knowledge in all fields, particularly in science, engineering, and technology, has reached a level which is unprecedented in human history. Keeping pace with this new knowledge has become essential if one has to survive, let alone succeed in the profession. Lifelong learning or continuous professional development has therefore become extremely important. I hope that throughout your professional life, you would use your skills in acquiring new knowledge so as to keep yourself up to date with all the developments that are taking place in your field around the world and explore how best these can be used in solving the problems you may be facing in your life. Based on my personal experience over the last 50 years, I can share with you something I have found very useful throughout my professional career. I have tried to acquire knowledge in various fields, not necessarily confining myself to the field of engineering in which I specialized. Only recently, I found that Thomas Huxley, the famous biologist from England, had said about 150 years back, and I quote, "Try to learn something about everything and everything about something." I repeat, try to learn something about everything and everything about something. Now, this is something which I have tried to practice without really being aware of what Huxley had said more than 150 years back. The third point which has changed the scenario is the revolution in information and communication technology, or ICT. Every day, we create 2.5 quintillion bytes of data. Now, you might be wondering, what is a quintillion? Quintillion is million, million, million. That is 18 zeros. So 2.5 followed by 18 zeros. That's the number of bytes of data which is being generated every day. And over 90% of the data in the world today has been created in the last 2 years alone. The availability of data on human behavior is quickly changing how decisions are made in different sectors and in different development contexts. Try to take advantage of the gateway to cyberspace opened up by ICT in acquiring new knowledge in your field. Dear graduating students, I note that out of the more than 800 graduates who will be formally receiving their bachelor's and master's degrees in various fields this afternoon, around 80% are from the business administration field. That is, receiving BBA, MBA, and EMBA degrees. Over the last three decades, Bangladesh has gradually emerged as an exporter of finished products rather than raw, unprocessed materials. The comparative advantage that we have over our competitors is likely to continue for a few more decades. However, the challenge for you as entrepreneurs would be to identify new and innovative products and increasing the efficiency of production. With your contribution, Sylhet region, which is strategically located very close to Northeast India and on the Asian highway leading to India, Myanmar, and China, can emerge as one of the major centers of our economic activity. So these are all opportunities for the graduates, young graduates who would be receiving the degree this afternoon. I expect some of you to pursue higher studies in well-known universities around the world and contribute to generation of new knowledge in your field. Unfortunately, at present, the contribution of Bangladeshis in generation of new knowledge is negligible. We have quite a rich tradition with a number of Bangladeshis achieving the highest global recognition in their fields. For example, Dr. Fazlur Rahman Khan, who was born in Dhaka, got his undergraduate degree in civil engineering in Dhaka from Engineering College, which is now BUET, went on to become one of the greatest structural engineers of the 20th century. His contribution to tall building design innovations made possible the construction of buildings more than 100 stories in height. More recently, some young scientists and engineers of Bangladeshi origin have become famous for their innovation and invention. I would mention only two. One of the co-founders of YouTube, which many of you use almost every day, is Javed Karim. And the founder of the revolutionary method of online education using YouTube is Salman Khan of Khan Academy, both of whom trace their ancestry to Bangladesh. I hope some of you would emerge available knowledge for the topic from textbooks or internet and clarifying their ideas through discussions and interactive method with the teacher acting more like a facilitator. The well-known universities around the world are gradually adopting this method and producing world-class graduates. I hope you would explore the possibilities and gradually introduce this method of learner-centered education. Dear graduating students, I am confident that with the knowledge and skills that you acquired and your ability to acquire new knowledge throughout your life, you would emerge as the vanguards of our journey along the path of development. I wish you success. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Jamilur Reza Chowdhury, for your elaborate and invaluable words of advice to the graduating students regarding the need of practical life and values. Ladies and gentlemen, we have reached the high point of this ceremony. It is time to confer degrees. Degrees are conferred upon those students who have fulfilled all the requirements prescribed for the degree. May I now request Professor Dr. Tufail Ahmed, the Dean of the Faculty of Business, to present the graduating students of the Faculty of Business to the Honorable Chairman of the second convocation, Professor Dr. Tufail Ahmed.
I request the graduating candidates under the Faculty of Business to rise, please. Honorable Chairman of the second convocation, with your kind permission, I present to you the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration, the candidates for the degree of Masters of Business Administration, the candidates for the degree of Executive Master of Business Administration. On behalf of the leading university, I certify to you that they have fulfilled all the conditions and requirements prescribed for the degrees for which they are candidates. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Tufail Ahmed. May I now request Professor Dr. Mushtaq Ahmed, the Dean of the Faculty of Modern Science, to present the graduating students of the Faculty of Modern Science to the Honorable Chairman of the second convocation, Professor Dr. Mushtaq Ahmed.
I request the graduating students under the Faculty of Modern Science to rise, please. Honorable Chairman of the second convocation, with your kind permission, I present to you the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Computer Science and Engineering. On behalf of the leading university, I certify to you that they have fulfilled all the conditions and requirements prescribed for the degree for which they are candidates. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Mushtaq Ahmed. May I now request Professor Nurul Islam Sardar, the Dean of the Faculty of Arts and Languages, to present the graduating students of the Faculty of Arts and Modern Languages to the Honorable Chairman of the Second Convocation, Professor Nurul Islam Sardar.
I request the graduating candidates under the Faculty of Arts and Modern Language to rise, please. Honorable Chairman of the Second Convocation, with your kind permission, I present to you the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in English and the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts in English. On behalf of the leading university, I certify to you that they have fulfilled all the conditions and requirements prescribed for the degree for which they are candidates. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Nurul Islam Sardar. May I now request Professor Dr. S.M. Saiful Islam, a Dean of the Faculty of Social Science, to present the graduating students of the Faculty of Social Science to the Honorable Chairman of the Second Convocation. Ladies and gentlemen, Professor Dr. S.M. Saiful Islam.
Good afternoon. I request the graduating students under the Faculty of Social Science to rise, please. Honorable Chairman of the Second Convocation, with your kind permission, I present to you the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Law and the candidates for the degree of Master of Law. On behalf of the leading university, I certify you that they have fulfilled all the conditions and requirements prescribed for the degree for which they are candidates. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Dr. S.M. Saiful Islam. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now at the peak of our today's august ceremony. May I now request Dr. Kazi Kholikujaman Ahmed, the Honorable Chairman of the Second Convocation, to kindly confer the degrees to the deserving candidates who have fulfilled all the conditions and requirements prescribed for the degree for which they are graduates today.
আমি সংশ্লিষ্ট আইন অনুযায়ী মহামান্য রাষ্ট্রপতি ও লিডিং ইউনিভার্সিটির চ্যান্সেলর কর্তৃক আমার উপর প্রদত্ত ক্ষমতা বলে আমার সম্মুখে উপস্থাপিত ছাত্রছাত্রীবৃন্দকে প্রযোজ্য অধিকার ও সুবিধাসহ তাদের প্রাপ্য স্ব স্ব ডিগ্রি প্রদান করছি এবং তাদেরকে আন্তরিক অভিনন্দন জ্ঞাপন করছি।
Thank you, Honorable Chairman of the Second Convocation. I now call upon all the candidates of undergraduate and graduate programs to move their tassels from left to right. You have now been graduated. Heartiest congratulations. Graduates, please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, among the high achievers in undergraduate and graduate programs, 17 students have been awarded medals under four categories for fulfilling the requirements set by the university. The awards are Chancellor's Medal, Vice Chancellor's Medal, Founder's Medal, and Co-Founder's Medal. Now, the medals will be awarded to the 17 recipient students by the Honorable Chairman of the Second Convocation, Chairman of the Board of Trustees, and the Vice Chancellor of leading university. I now request the recipients of Chancellor's Award to come to the stage one by one and receive the medals from the Honorable Chairman of the Second Convocation, Dr. Kazi Kholikujaman Ahmed. The first name is Muhammad Hafizur Rahman Khan, BBA Fall 2010. Ladies and gentlemen, please note that all the chancellors, award holders have got CGPA 4. Next is S.M. Atikur Rahman, BBA Fall 2010. Next, Jhuma Rani Pal, BBA Spring 2011. Next, Mohammad Abdul Muhit Chowdhury. Then, Indrani Rai. And the next and last one is Mohammad Hafiz. Thank you, sir, for awarding the Chancellor's medals to the recipients.
Please, jump.
I now request the recipients of Vice Chancellor's Award to come to the stage one by one and receive the medals from the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Leading University, Professor Dr. M.D. Kismatul Hassan. The first award holder is